What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about enabling Intune, MDM, and the security defaults within your Azure portal. So let's get right into that. All right, so logging into your Azure portal, typically just open up your favorite browser. Within the address bar, you're just going to type in portal.azure.com, hit enter, log in. Just make sure you locate the Azure Active Directory service, and it's going to load you here. So on the left-hand side, we are going to locate the Mobility MDM and MAM feature. So click on it, and it's going to take you here. Now, if you have a legit license that gives you Microsoft Intune, for example, if you have the Microsoft 365 Premium license, it should give you this Microsoft Intune option. So we are going to click on it, and once you click on it, you have two options, two user scopes to enable. Now, from my understanding, when I did some research, if you enable both of these scopes, there's going to be some type of conflict. But for this video, we're going to focus on sliding the MDM user scope to all. You are able to narrow it down to some and specify a user group or a security group that you have to do a pilot test. And then when you're ready, you're able to push it out to everyone within your organization. So once you're done here, we're going to locate that save button. We're going to click on it. And on the upper right-hand side, it should say update Microsoft Intune settings successfully updated. Awesome, right? So let's head back into your Azure Active Directory overview. And then from here, we're going to locate the properties. So click on properties, and it should take you here. All the way in the bottom, you're going to see manage security defaults. Just click on that hyperlink. Once you're here, just make sure that it is enabled. By default, Microsoft already enables it, but you are able to disable the security defaults and then configure it the way that you want it within your organization. Hopefully, I'm going to do those videos for you guys later, how to disable it and then configure securities for your tenant. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.